Good morning, children. Welcome to the English class. Like last year, this year also, you have two books, Real English and Everyday English Grammar. Today, we are going to start the first story from the Real English book. Now, all of us love pets. You may have pets of your own, or you may have seen pets owned by your neighbors, your relatives, or people near you. Now, why do people keep pets? Dogs are the most popular pets, and they are popular because they are very friendly and faithful. Many people keep cats as pets because cats are considered to be intelligent. Then there are people who have parakeets, parrots, rabbits, and some other pets. Parakeets are kept because they can be taught to speak like humans. In the past, they were very popular as companions of sailors and pirates because they could be taught to speak. Now, today's story is about an old sailor and his constant companion, a talking macaw. The name of the story is The Cranky Macaw. Old sailor Johnny Jay loved the sea. From the year he turned 12, he started sailing. Since then, it has been 66 years. He has sailed across the world. He has seen many countries, but the sea was his home. He did not like to live on the land for a long period of time. He had a small cabin on the island of Guyana, where he chose to stay instead with his family, which lived on a nearby island. Now, please pay attention to the interesting names of the characters. The sailor's name is Johnny Jay, and he loved to sail. He started sailing since he was 12 years old, and since then he has been sailing for about 66 years. And he lived on the island of Guyana in a small cabin. Whenever he was not sailing, then also he liked to live alone in a cabin on the island of Guyana, and his family used to be on an island which was next to this island. Johnny Jay has had only one constant friend over the years. Crazy Coot, as he was known, spoke like a man but with a very odd shrieking tone. Now, he had only one friend all along, and the name was Crazy Coot. He could talk and speak like a man but in a very shrieking, irritating, loud tone. Crazy Coot and Johnny Jay both loved the sea, and like all sailors, enjoyed their own company. Now, both of them, Crazy Coot and Johnny Jay, loved the sea, loved sailing, and they liked to be alone. Meeting people always made them cranky. When they had to meet people, they would become very bad-tempered and behave badly. But what made Crazy Coot really special was that he was a macaw, a kind of South American parrot. His plumage, that means the feathers covering his body, and tail feathers were scarlet in color, that is bright red in color. The rump, that is the backside, was of light blue, and the upper wings of yellow. Macaws are very intelligent and can be taught to speak like human beings. Crazy Coot had a bad temper and, when irritated, would shout almost like humans. He had a very bad temper, that means he used to get angry very fast, and when someone irritated him or annoyed him, he would shout almost like human beings. He loved watching old movies with Johnny J. His favorite pastime was watching old movies and could imitate sounds of gunfire. He could copy the sounds of gunfire. He could also speak some dialogues from some movies. He could speak some dialogues from the movies he watched. He loved to whistle. Whenever he saw a girl or a woman, he would whistle loudly and pretend to faint. He also threw his favorite food. And do you know what was his favorite food? Sunflower seeds throughout Johnny J's house. And loved to hide behind things. Johnny J and Crazy Coot were a well-matched pair. In today's language, what we call made for each other. They were both stubborn. They liked to do what they liked. And they did not want to change. And solitary. They wanted to be alone. They just like each other's company and no one else. They wanted near them. Johnny J's older sister, Missy May, was not fond of the Macaw. She would visit them when Johnny J and Crazy Coot were staying in their house on the island of Guyana. Whenever Missy May was around, Crazy Coot, he would screech at her. Now, Crazy Coot and Johnny J's elder sister, Missy May, were not fond of each other. And whenever Missy May was around, he would screech at her, that is, make long, loud, unpleasant sounds. Then he would make sounds of police siren and gunshots just to irritate her and then laugh aloud. Missy May, as you can imagine, was not very happy with Crazy Coot. That means Crazy Coot did not like Missy May, and Missy May also was not fond of Crazy Coot. One afternoon, Missy May came to visit Johnny J. When she did not find her brother in the house, she decided to sleep in the parlor for some time. She came to visit her brother. The brother was not there. So she decided to sleep in the parlor, which is a small room for the guests, for some time. She ignored Crazy Coot. She did not pay attention to Crazy Coot who was there. Now, Crazy Coot liked people to pay attention to him. So he was offended by this. And so he started muttering something, started speaking something to himself, and then went and hid behind some books. Then, when Crazy Coot was hiding behind books, and Missy May was sleeping on the chair, then you know what happened? Then a thief climbed in from the window of the parlor. He started putting things in his bag quietly because he did not want to wake up Missy May. But the thief did not know about Crazy Coot. Now, why did the thief not know about that Crazy Coot was there? Because Crazy Coot was not seen. He was hiding behind books. The only person who could be seen was Missy May sleeping on the chair. Out of nowhere, someone shouted, "You thief, you kill me, leave me alone. I call police, you go to jail." It was followed by the sounds of police siren and gunshots. Suddenly terrified, the thief stood as if he had turned into stone. Now when the thief heard the sound of the police siren, the sound of gunshot, and he realized that the police was there to catch him, he suddenly turned into stone. That means he became so shocked. He was so shocked that he became like a statue. He was very, very scared. The thief jumped to escape. So he jumped to run away. And at the same time, the sister shot up from the chair because the noise or the sound he made while jumping up to run away woke up Missy May. Surprised, the thief tripped The thief stumbled on something and fell and struck his head on the table. And struck his head on the table, and then you know what happened? He fainted. Missy May quickly then called the police, who arrested the thief, feeling ecstatic at being saved. Now, Missy May was very, very happy that she was saved. So, Missy May went to Crazy Coot and she wanted to show her appreciation by petting the bird. But what do you think the already irritated Crazy Coot do? Crazy Coot said, "You thief, you kill me, leave me alone, I call police, you go to jail." Ah, the police froze when they heard Crazy Coot. Now, the police was also very surprised when they heard these dialogues being said or being delivered by Crazy Coot. And then they realized that what had happened and they burst out laughing. They understood how Missy May was able to escape unhurt. Now, what made them laugh? The police laughed because they realized that there was no gunshot, there was no siren, and the dialogues were all by Crazy Coot, which scared the thief. He tripped and he fell down and fainted. And then they also understood how Missy May was able to escape. How was she able to escape unhurt? She was able to escape unhurt. She was saved by a talking bird or a talking macaw. Now that is all for today. We will do some more exercises on this lesson tomorrow. But please go to the Real English app today if you have already downloaded it. If you have not, please download it today and go and watch the first video on the cranky macaw. Thank you, children. Till we meet again.